Hello students, today we will discuss DC machine which comes under the course Basic Electrical Engineering. First we will see what is a machine. Any device that can reduce human effort and time in doing a particular work, even we can say that if a device which is enhancing the performance of a human being as well as the efficiency is increased, this is a machine. Machine can reduce the human effort and time of doing a particular work, so that the machines are very useful in this era. Electrical machines. Electrical machines may be classified in two general ways. The machines which works on the direct current are called DC machine, like DC generator and DC motor, and the other types of machine comes under the AC machine, which works on the alternating current like transformer, induction machine and synchronous machine. DC machine, as you know that our subject is this time we are considering only DC machine. The induction machine will be there in the next video. In this video we will discuss only DC machine. DC machine, as we have discussed, that can be classified into two types, such as motor and generator. What is a motor? If we talk about the motor is a device or a machine which transfer the input of electrical energy into the mechanical energy. That means in motor you will provide the electric current in the input side and you will get the mechanical force in the form of torque in the output side. In generator, it is just opposite of that of motor, because it will change the mechanical energy into electrical energy. That means you will provide torque or force by any means which is known as prime mover. It may be steam turbine. Generally, turbine is there to provide mechanical energy in the input. It may be steam turbine or diesel generator or a motor. Diesel generator you cannot use, you can use motor. So it will be converted into a electrical energy. That means electrical output in the form of voltage or current you will get in the output side. What is the basic principle of working a generator? Here you can see that Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction is the basic principle of working how the generator works. What does it say? It says that whenever a magnetic we will use pen to draw the things which we are discussing. Electromagnetic induction principle says that when you are rotating a coil, this red portion is a coil, in the magnetic field, that means N and S poles. Between N and S poles, these are the magnetic field lines. So when you are rotating this magnetic coil in the magnetic field, the flux, that is magnetic field lines, will be cut by this coil, and due to this cutting of flux, that means through the area covered by the coil, the d phi by dt will be there. That means the rate of change of flux. The rate of change of flux will be there, that will produce, or we can say induce, and EMF in between the terminal of the coil, across the terminal, we can say, across the terminal of the coil. So this positive or negative is the polarity that shows that DC current is coming outside the coil. So how the DC current comes, that is a different way. We will discuss it later, as the coil will rotate in the magnetic field will generate only alternating current, but it is converted into a DC current by using a particular mean, which is commutator. This blue portion is commutator, and this will turn the alternating current into direct current. As you are seeing that polarity is there, that means it is direct current. Okay, so to find out the direction of the current, we can use Fleming right hand rule. How we can use the Fleming right hand rule? If we will spread our first three finger of the right hand, then first finger, that means thumb, will define the direction of the motion. Then the second finger will define the direction of field, and third finger will define the direction of current. In case of generator, we are having the direction of motion, the direction of motion of the conductor, that means this conductor, whether this conduction is going upward or downward. This will depend on the rotation which we are providing in the input side by using turbine. It may be clockwise or anti-clockwise. That means in this case, this is clockwise. That means this conductor will move upward. So the direction of motion will be like this, and the direction of field will be always from north to south, like this. From north to south. So in this case, we can see that the direction of current will be like that, or we should use some like that, from here to here, because negative sign is there, that means the current will flow towards the negative sign. Okay, so this is the mean by which we can find out the direction of the current in case of generator. Basic principle of motor is exactly reverse to that of the generator we have used. In case of motor, the working principle works like that, that when a current carrying coil is kept in a magnetic field, in generator the coil was not carrying current, the current was generated, but in case of motor, the coil will already carrying the current. So when a current, this red portion, red arrow will show the direction of the current. According to that, the direction of force on the conductor will be defined. It may be upward or it may be downward. We will see by using left hand rule, Fleming left hand rule, which will be used in case of motor to find out the direction of the force. So in case of current carrying conductor, is when the current carrying conductor like this is placed in a magnetic field, that means from north to south, the force will act on the conductor. Okay, now we have to find out the direction of the force, whether this coil will rotate in the clockwise or anti-clockwise. It will depend that this conductor is moving towards upward or downward, which we can find out by using the Fleming left hand rule. How does it work? It works on the same principle. If we'll spread our first three fingers of the left hand in perpendicular to each other, then the direction of magnetic field will be defined by using second finger, and direction of current will be like third finger, and the direction of force in which we are interested in case of motor. In student, you should notice that in case of generator, we were interested to find out the direction of current in the conductor, but in case of motor, we are interested to find out the direction of the force in the conductor. Okay, so if naturally this conductor will move upward, then this conductor would have to move in the downward direction, so it will move in the clockwise direction, and the output we will have on the shaft. Okay, now construction of DC machine. Now we will discuss the construction. The construction of any machine is divided into two parts. In every rotating machine, we have distributed the construction into two parts. One of them, which is stator, that means static condition, and other one is rotor, which remain in rotating condition. Okay, in stator we also call it a field system. Stator we also known as field system, that means field winding. Field winding means to execute the north and south pole in the machine, we use field system. And the other one is rotor, that means armature, that means the conductor which we are using to rotate. That why it is rotor. Stator is a static part which we have discussed, and rotor is the rotating part. Though there is two parts, one is field system, that means magnetic field, and other one is armature conductors, which will be rotated in between the field. Construction feature, which we have discussed, main parts, the main parts of the DC machine. First is, we will discuss stator. This part is stator outside, and the poles are mounted. You are looking that poles are mounted on the stator. You can see here N, S, N, S are the poles. How the N pole is created? By using field winding. That means we will use the field winding to execute the poles, whether it is N or S, and it will depend on the direction of current in the field winding. Okay, so at the stator we have mounted poles. Over poles, the field winding, this black shaded portion is field winding, has been put to execute the magnetic field poles all around the machine. It is, you can see that it is in like parabolic shape. Poles are like that. That means to execute the field in the radial direction or uniformly distributed. Okay, now the second we comes on the rotor part. The rotor part is inside the stator. It starts with the rotor conductor. You can see this portion. This portion is rotor conductor. The armature core is there. This white portion is armature core. Over core, the armature slots are there, this white portion are slots. In between the slots, the armature conductor, you can see in the round shape, the armature conductors are there. So this is according to the principle, the armature conductors are the current carrying coil is kept in a magnetic field. Okay, so the principle is like that. Current carrying coil, whether it is current carrying in case of motor or it will be normal coil in case of generator. A frame and yoke is the outer part of the machine which will be used for the mechanic to provide the mechanical strength to the machine. The shaft is a portion of the machine attached with rotor to provide mechanical force to the motor or to get to the generator or to get the mechanical output from the motor. Okay, so yoke is a outer frame machine used for protection and provide the flux path. Pole, we have discussed that it is to house the field winding, and it is laminated. You all know that lamination, we use the lamination for reducing the eddy currents losses. Field winding to distribute the magnetic flux in between the machine. Copper winding you can use to set up the field. Okay, then pole shoe, the face of the pole, this kind of portion. Okay, concave shape distribute the main flux. Okay, it will like that, and conductor will be mount like that. Okay, so the direction of the current will define that it will be N or S. It will be N or S. Interpole is an advanced setup which is used in between the main poles to reduce the armature reaction. Okay, now the rotating part will be discussed. How the pen will be there? Okay, now it is there. Rotating part of DC machine, it is also known as armature. We have discussed shaft to use. How we will couple the generator shaft to the prime mover by using shaft and load. How we will provide the load on the motor? Load means mechanical output. If you are sometimes most of the times we use gear in form of loads to power transmit from one place to other place. We use gears. So in case of motor, to produce the load on the motor, we will use shaft. Okay, commutator and brushes are very important. Commutator is especially a very important part of the in case of DC generator and motor, because one thing you should be remember that you cannot generate DC current ever. You will always generate alternating current, but in case of DC generator or motor, you required DC direct current. So it is required to convert the alternating current which is producing or which produce always into the DC current. So we use commutator. Commutator is a special segment of the machine which converts alternating current into the direct current. Okay. So the alternating current will be converted into DC current. It is also known as mechanical rectifier. Remember, the electronic rectifier is made up of diodes, four diodes or two diodes, but the mechanical rectifier is made up of commutator. It is also called mechanical rectifier. That means rectifier is a device which convert AC to DC. Okay, commutator. Carbon brushes, which is used to collect the supply or to provide the supply to the commutator. It is basically a static part of the rotor which is connected over the commutator to collect the supply or to pass the supply into the conductor commutator. The complete view of machine is like that. You can see the cross section, the field portion is the field portion is there, the rotating portion is there, it is wave shaped, slots are there, in between the slots armature coils are mounted, field coils, armature coils, it will be side view. Laminated. Okay, so this was the DC machine. In the next chapter, we will discuss the other part of the DC machine like EMF equation, motor torque, and speed control or some other topics. So thank you for today. Thank you, students.